part one in my series on Chizarira National Park. This is just a broad overview of the park. Now, Chizarira is without doubt the wildest, most remote, and least visited of all the national parks in Zimbabwe. I haven't seen the current figures, but I know a couple of years ago, during the entire year, there were less than 100 visitors to this park. So if it's isolation, wilderness, remoteness that you're seeking, this is definitely the place for you. Now, highlights of Chizarira Park, I would say, are of course the dramatic vistas, incredible views looking north towards Zambia, to the south over the park itself, wide vistas, fantastic vegetation here. Probably more variation in the vegetation in Chizarira than in any other park. Right here on the top of the hills, you've got the brachystegia woodland, and then down to the south of the park, you get open mapani scrubland, looking a lot like mana pools, and everything in between, terminalia combritum, there's baobabs in the south of the park. It's got it all. It really is a fantastic sight. In terms of wildlife, Chizarira was once very densely populated with wildlife. The park was formed in the late 50s as the rising floodwaters from Kariba sent wildlife scurrying up into the escarpment. And in the 1970s and 1980s, overpopulation of elephant was in fact a serious problem here and attracted a lot of attention from ecologists. Sadly, since then, a sustained period of poaching has significantly reduced the elephant numbers. There were rhino here at one point as well, but they've also sadly gone. Of course, the reduction in the elephant population has now given the vegetation a chance to recover. Chizarira is now undergoing a new lease of life. It's also under improved management. There are a number of organizations here supporting national parks to try to rehabilitate Chizarira. One of the things that they've managed to do is to rehabilitate some of the roads around the park. The park is covered by a fairly extensive network of roads, but not all of them are passable. And as you'll see in some of my other videos, even the ones that are can be pretty challenging. This is 4x4 country. If that's what you're into, and I certainly am, this is the place for you. One of the things that visitors to Chizarira really appreciate about it is the opportunity to go walking in places where you feel that no one else has ever trodden. You can either do that by bringing in or hiring a professional guide, or just by coming to the park's office and hiring a ranger to go and accompany you on a walk. It's a very, very well worth exercise. You are probably not going to see a whole lot of wildlife while you're here. There are elephant. We've heard lion almost every night. Of course, there are hyenas, plenty of leopard in these rocks and cliffs. But I would say that the birding, perhaps more than the mammals, would be a top attraction for this park. Some beautiful birds. There are over 400 species of birds found in Chizarira. That's 70% of all the birds found in Zimbabwe. You can see them right here. One of the highlights for me personally has been the tiger falcon, which is an extraordinary aerial display, and the several pairs living in the cliffs here. For the real twitchers amongst you, if you're after that elusive big five, come and check out the Angolan pita here. Good luck finding it, but if you do, it'll be well worth your while. Of course, for many people, it's simply the sense of isolation that makes Chizarira special. Just sitting here in your camp, relaxing from the fairly arduous journey that you will have undertaken to get here, and knowing that you're basically the only people in a very large area. Nearly 2,000 square kilometers, Chizarira is the third largest national park in the country, and as I said, absolutely the least visited. So welcome to this magnificent park, one of my very favorite in Zimbabwe.